Hello, hello. So, where do I start? I think this is going to be a very long video because we are in Watch Dogs 2, and even for those ones who are lucky enough to have like a single 2080 Ti, you'll notice that the settings, the quality settings for this game in particular, they are very, it's going to give you a headache because you'll want to get like the best performance and the best quality in this type of game, and you kind of want to push the graphic card to the limit, and then you hit a wall because you realize that not even with a 2080 Ti, you ain't gonna reach like a playable frame rate in this game if you apply the maximum settings. And you can see an example here. And we are using, just to let you know, we are using a Sly Connection 2080 Ti, 64 gigs of RAM, i9-7960X, everything on a Rampage 6 Extreme. And for the monitor, we are using PG27UQ from ASUS, which is capable of giving us 4K resolution in 144 Hz. And we're gonna talk about the quality settings shortly. As you can see, everything looks amazing, like photorealistic, the vegetation, and basically everything. But the frame rate is terrible. For me, 30 frames per second using this kind of hardware is not acceptable. Even you see there are certain areas in the game, like if you go here in the woods where you have like a lot of vegetations and some vegetation and some movement, like you have cars passing and this kind of things, you're gonna go below 20 frames per second, which is, as I was saying, unacceptable. Yeah, it looks nice, it looks great, but you need some kind of gaming experience as well, So we ain't gonna use this kind of settings, but probably you're wondering what kind of settings we are using. And let me show you. Let me get in this car and just come here a little bit. I'm gonna lower the music down from settings as well. You know, I was kind of pissed as well when I saw the performance. So let's see this. There you go. So ultra, basically everything is on ultra. Extra details, we are using 100%. This Shadows is a new technology. Hybrid frustum trace shadows, crisp, accurate, hard shadows, which it then soften using a special filter. So basically, this one, because I've tested it before, it gives you a more realistic image to the object surrounding you and that you can everywhere that you can see. So for me, this is a must. You must have this one. Now I know that a lot of people will say, oh, these are not the maximum settings. Well, they are, because you don't need all the filters to be enabled, because some of them, they are doing the same thing, like multi-sample anti-aliasing. You don't need this if you're playing the game in 4K. It's like cheating because it's downscaling and then upscaling, and there's no point of using it, so you don't need this one. This is why temporal filtering is off as well, because when you enable this one will be enabled as well. Ambient occlusion, again, this is a filter for, it's a technique developed by Nvidia and gives you a more realistic, basically is working on the shadows of the objects surrounding you and making them more realistic. Now, post-process anti-aliasing, this is as good as SMAA, but you will get much less penalty in matter of performance than using SMAA. So these ones are, let's call them maximum settings. And as you can see, I'm not saying is not playable. It is, even at 30 frames per second. And somehow, because you have this sly connection, you have these feelings that that you actually see more frames per second, but you don't. The thing is, sometimes when you have like intense action, you have those glitches, you know, you have those pause in the image, like the frame drops below, let's say 15 frames per second, and then there's a big problem. So obviously you can't play the game in this kind of settings, not for a long time anyway, only, you know, to see the city and this. Yeah, okay, but who needs this? I mean, I just finished like a few days ago, I finished this the first Watch Dogs, and I must say this is a huge step ahead in matter of graphics and gameplay and the way how they made things look more realistic. And I've seen a few days ago like a comparison between GTA 5 and this one. Let me tell you, GTA 5 doesn't come not even close in matter of graphic like the with Watch Dogs though. So let's try a different type of setting. Let's see what you need and what you actually don't need. And I'll tell you about this one over here. You will find, look, field of view. This one you can crank it up to 110. But as the warning says there, if you go over this basic 70 degrees, this is field of view, the image that you see from that they are very far away and you see them, and they are, and it refers to the details that you can see on those objects. So you don't really need too much details applied to the objects that you see far away, because you're focusing on what surrounds you and what's next to you. So let's put this to 70%, and I think this is enough. You can play with this one, you can go and see how it is to go all the way to 110, which is absolutely not necessary. And there's another thing that it can happen. You can have like artifacts in the far view of your view, let's say like this. And here, extra details. I know a lot of people are going like below, I don't know, 50% extra detail. You can play with this one as well, and actually we will try to see how it is and if there's a significant difference. So we were in like 35 frames per second before applying these two settings. Let's see how it is now. 10 frames per second more. I'm not noticing any difference in in graphics, so nothing noticeable. The thing that bothers me is that between, let's say, high and ultra settings, there's not a big difference. So look, frame rate went to 20 something, which from my point of view, if this is the gain that I'm getting, then I'm gonna put them back on, you know, like there's no big difference at all. Like, oh, police just fucked me over. Okay, I'm gonna try to run from the cops. I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Now I have more cars after me. Great. So let's try to talk about the game while we are running from the police. There, this is amazing. Okay, I think I lost them. Yeah. And they hit me, I didn't hit them. Anyway. So, with what other settings we can play with? We're gonna try to play a little bit with the filters. Look, this is... You see this this road, this... I don't know how I say it in English. Obviously, English is not my first language. It looks very realistic. Like this one, the hard one. Look. And you can achieve that kind of realisticness with this one from here. With with this one from here. If you put this one on Ultra, let's see what happens. Ultra, if we get a better frame rate. FXAR. Let's put like this one off as well and let's see what happens. There you go. This might be a solution. Same realisticness of the surroundings. Less crisp on the this one on the vegetation. They look very realistic. They don't look as fresh. With the it's your clothes, your style, your story. And I think that's a setup for me. I could go for like 40 frames per second and the image, like the gameplay, looks very smooth. Yeah. Ooh, 30 frames per second, there you go. Still not enough. And that's true, if I want like serious frame rate, I could go below 4K, but I said that I'm gonna do this setup, but I'm gonna play everything in 4K, so I'm not going below that. I know some of you might think I'm an idiot or a spoiled brat, but I didn't pay like over £2,000 for a monitor to play these games in 2K. So let's check something else. Settings, go to videos, and extra details go on 0. FXAA gone off, so no quality filters basically. Except those ones that they are used by Nvidia to give you like a very realistic image for the objects surrounding you. And now there's a... But there's a noticeable difference in graphics. I mean, I don't know how it looks there. But for me, it's noticeable here. Much, much better performance, as you can see. But you get like a serious... Yeah, there's a serious quality downgrade. So we're gonna try to activate some things. I don't like motion blur or bloom. San Francisco fog, yes, definitely. You need that. So let's go this one. Should we use this? Yes, I don't know. If I'm using this, I just kill the whole system, I think. Yeah. Ambient occlusion. Yeah. Okay. High, yeah, high. Okay. I think we're gonna kill the system now. There you go. that I can't believe it. Look at this frame rate. 60. It's not even playable. And this is on slide. But oh shit. Again I hit the police car. Jesus. Is absolutely unplayable. 5 frames per second, there you go. This is what I was saying in the beginning of this video. There are some settings that you don't actually need because they contradict each other and you get something that you see there. So this one you don't need, just off. This one, FXAA is okay. Motion blur, this is good. This is good. Extra quality. No. Okay, let's run from the police first. Plus, there's a whole discussion now. I had it in my previous video. Like, if you're using 4K resolution and you have this kind of pixel density, and it's good that now we have a chase because you can see the frame rate while we have some more action. But the discussion is, if you have this kind of pixel density in 4K, do you really need any kind of quality filters? Because this one's they used to be used when we had those low resolutions, and those resolutions made the objects look very you had like a lot of hard shapes on the objects, they didn't look very realistic. So the quality filters were coming to shape those objects. Do we really need those ones now? Probably yes, because we still have edges, like hard edges, and you need a quality filter to shape that, but not as much as we used to need them in, or we still need them in lower resolutions. 911, state your emergency. There you go. So you've seen the frame rate in a high action scene as well. Let's go to the bridge a little bit. It's perfect, and now it's raining as well, so let's see the performance on the bridge. It's very demanding, this scene here. So I'm planning to play this game. I don't know exactly which are gonna be the settings that I'm gonna use, but probably this is a start for me. I'm not gonna use the any other quality filters. Maybe I'm gonna increase the, I want a car, maybe I'm gonna increase the extra details, because to be honest, from what I've tested till now, there's not a big plus like in performance. Like even if you switch them off, and we're gonna, oh what the hell, I thought he's gonna stop. And I'm gonna show you now, but I want to get that car. This one. Stop! Oh, you're being a smartass. Okay. Get the fuck out. Okay. Did I hit it? No, I didn't. Okay, so let's try now. Extra detail. So you see that it is not such a big difference in adding, let's say, I don't know, 100%. And if you see, VRAM usage actually tells you we have 10 gigs available, almost 11 gigs available, and we are using half of it, adding 100% extra details. And let's see what kind of penalty boost, penalty damage we are taking. Almost nothing. But look at the difference in and the image quality. It's amazing, much better. Even the colors are brighter, and everything looks much better. Look at the sunset. and the shadows. Absolutely amazing. Yeah. Extra details 100%. That's the settings. That's a must. Cyberdriver, fuck off. Yeah, so these are a starting point for the settings. So look, 28. Oh my god, I'm gonna have a headache. Look, when you're going into the city, now you will see the performance. It's unplayable. We're going back to the searching pad. Yeah, when you have like close spaces, the performance is good. When you go outside and other things start to come into the game, performance is absolutely crap. And it's not because the Sly connection is not scaling well. Is doing good, much better than I've seen, for example, in Metro Exodus, which is totally shit. But this is the reason why we don't play Ubisoft games in extreme settings, because you ain't gonna be able to reach a playable frame rate. Doesn't matter what you have under your hood. So yeah, this is the conclusion. I still have to find the good settings for this light connection, to find a balance between quality and frame rate. It's gonna be pretty, you know, demanding a matter of time, but I will find them and I will let you know soon. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed the walk through San Francisco. I think this is, so yeah, it's San Francisco. And I myself can't wait to start playing this game for real. It looks amazing. That's great. Okay, take care of yourselves and stay safe, stay indoors, and, you know, play video games. Thank you for watching.